Hey guys, me again, Dan Duran from GetCyber, and today we're going to go on with this marathon, Hack the Box Marathon. Starting point, learn the basics of penetration testing. We are in tier zero and number six, Preignition number six. So let me just do a reset of this box in here. There you go. So we can start from the beginning, and there you go. This is my IP address, and let's get going. All right, number one, directory brute forcing is a technique to use to check a lot of paths on a web server to find hidden pages, which is another name for this: local inclusion, dirbusting, or hash cracking. Local file inclusion is usually done for elevating privileges once you already pawn a user and you want to get the system. And then hash cracking is basically brute forcing. So what you want to do is download the hashes and then try to crack them to get the passwords out of them. So this would be number two, dirbusting. Submit answer, and that's what it is. Task number two, what switch do we use for nmap scan to specify that we want to perform version detection? That one is minus SV, so small s and then V, so stealth version. And that's correct. What does nmap report is the service identify as running on port 80 TCP? Now, this is not just nmap. So on port 80 TCP, it's always going to be HTTP. So HTTP, just like 443 is for HTTPS. Submit the answer, and there we go. What server name and version of the service is running on port 80 TCP? All right, for this one, we're gonna have to launch our terminal. So let me just click on terminal, and then I'm going to do an nmap like that. And it's gonna be on port 80. I'm also gonna put here O, there you go, and maybe SS, there, perfect. Let's launch this. There you go. Nginx 1.14.2. So let's just copy this. Shift Control C to copy. Paste it in here. And there you go. What switch do we use to specify to GoBuster we want to perform a dirbusting? So now what we have to do is try to find different folders inside of dirbuster. So that would be dir, like that. All right, task number six. When using GoBuster to dirbust, what switch do we add to make sure it finds PHP pages? And that would be X, right? So minus X and then PHP. I think it's capital X. I don't remember. Yes. So that's correct. What page is found during our dirbusting activity? So, okay. So let's go and do GoBuster, right? So if you don't have it installed, just type in app install GoBuster like that. I already have it. So that's okay. So let's do GoBuster, GoBuster, and then H. Okay, so here are all the flags that you need, right? So W for the word list that we're gonna use. That's very important. And minus X for some reason is not displayed in here. So you can do man GoBuster to be able to see more information. Oh, there is no manual for GoBuster. Okay, all right. Let's do that. Then just trust me. This is what you do. This is what you put in there. So GoBuster, and what we want in here is there, right? Like that. And then we're going to put X, and I think I already have it in here. There you go. I already done it before. So W for the word list, and we're going to use the word list from Derb. All right, so let's get going on this. And there you go. And we already found the page. So it is admin.php. So let me just create another tab in here. And I want to show you something really cool. So here, I'm going to go CD and then user share word list. And inside of word list, we have a whole bunch of different types of word list, right? So for example, we have rock you in here. We have a derb, we have dirbuster, and you can actually look at the different types of word lists for cracking passwords and doing this kind of stuff. All right, let's go back. We can see that we have an admin page. Now, every time you get something that is in port 80, you're going to be able to actually go into a tab and then type in the IP address and get that. So in this case, you can see that this is an Nginx page, welcome page. Sometimes you're not able to go through the IP, so you have to create a host, but that's okay. We'll go through that in a different tutorial. So, all right, so now type in admin.php, right? And here it is, the console. So let's go back to here and then type in admin.php submit answer. There you go. What is the HTTP status reported by GoBuster? Okay, so if we go back to GoBuster, here you go. Okay, so status 200. So 200 is a very common status that indicates that there's something out there. Now, if you get a 404, for example, 400, then it either means that it's not available. So 404, it doesn't exist. 403, you're not allowed to get in. All right, so submit that answer and then submit the flag. So how do we get into this console? Well, let's try different combinations. So for example, admin and then password, that doesn't work. Let's try admin, and that does work. Okay, perfect. So let's just copy this, go back to the interface, paste this, and submit the flag. And perfect, that's done. That was super easy using GoBuster or Dirb or dirbusting. They're all the same type of tools. They're used for fuzzing or finding directories, finding pages inside of websites. And they're great because if you find something that you like, then you can actually search for more information and then possibly hack that interface and stuff. So if you have any comments, any questions, make sure you post them below. And I hope to see you in the next video. Cheers.